I got another mail-in laptop repair, so let's see what's wrong with this one. Wow, this is a 13-inch Alienware gaming laptop, and the customer's notes said that they sent it to Dell to replace the battery, and Dell says it needs a new motherboard. Well, let's see if we can fix this motherboard instead. The first thing I see is that it does not turn on, and the lights turn off on the charger. I will need to pull out this motherboard and get it under the microscope. Now, I will use my multimeter to measure all the power rails and check for a short. Well, this is not good. There's a short on the integrated NVIDIA graphics card. One of these dual MOSFETs are shorted to the main 19 power rail, sending all the power straight to the GPU. This GPU could be toast, but let me replace this bad MOSFET here and see if I can get this laptop to turn on. Okay, the short is gone. Will it turn on? Yes. Okay, but we will need to boot the Windows to see if the NVIDIA GPU survived. And no, the laptop just reboots, which means the GPU is bad. So there are two choices here. To convert the laptop into Intel graphics only by removing all the MOSFETs on the NVIDIA GPU to disable it, or do what Dell said and replace the motherboard. This laptop got delivered today and there's a major problem with it. So let's see exactly what's wrong with this gaming laptop. Well, first, it won't turn on, and the light goes off on the charger, which is really bad news. This laptop will need a new motherboard, so let me grab one from the warehouse. No, that would be too easy. Instead of just replacing this motherboard, let me remove it and see what's wrong with it. Okay, to the thermal camera microscope it goes. I will need to inject voltage into the motherboard to find the shorted component. Do you see how this is lighting up like a Christmas tree? This capacitor will need to be replaced. Okay, time to reassemble and test. Moment of truth. Boom, sweet. Wait, what? The battery's not charging. Well, back to the microscope it goes. Looks like this MOSFET is shorted also and stuck on. Let me grab a new one and get it replaced. Okay, time to reassemble, and moment of truth, take two. Boom, sweet success. So if you need a repair, link is in our bio. I got another mail-in laptop repair, so let's see what's wrong with this one. This subscriber sent in this 17-inch Alienware gaming laptop because it shut off while they were playing a game and never came back on. This looks like another dead motherboard because it shorts out the charger when it's plugged in. Time to open it up. Now I'll reuse my multimeter to measure all the power rails to check for a short. I could see a dead short on the main 19-volt power rail. Time to see if I could fix this motherboard. I will need to pull out this board and get it under the microscope. To find the shorted component, I will inject voltage into the 19-volt power rail, but I will limit it to 1 volt just in case. Well, uh-oh, there's a short on the integrated NVIDIA graphics card. One of these all-in-one MOSFET driver ICs are shorted to the main 19-volt power rail, sending all the power straight to the GPU. This GPU could be dead, but let me replace this bad MOSFET package here and see if I can get this laptop to turn on. Okay, the short is gone. Will it turn on? Yes. I was able to run the Firmark GPU stress test for more than an hour. This shows that the protection circuits did their job and kept the GPU safe. This repair was only $200 and I earned another happy subscriber. New day, new Alienware to repair. This time, this mail-in laptop repair was damaged by the customer, who said they disassembled the machine to access and clean the fan and heatsink. Then the screen went black and started displaying an error code. It doesn't take me long to see that there's a bad burn on the motherboard. Let's take a closer look under the microscope. I can see that the chip was destroyed, which is part of the LCD backlight circuit. And looking at the LCD connector, I could see that the customer bent a pin and shorted out the LCD cable when reassembling it. Chips that are burned this badly are basically welded to the board. Let's remove the chip and see how bad the damage is. Well, it's pretty bad. We'll need to replace these solder pads. This will get you an idea how small these pads are. Okay, the new pads are in. Time to install the new chip. And will it fix it? No. Unfortunately, there was catastrophic damage to this laptop. Just say no to cracked chips, because this tiny capacitor brought this massive gaming laptop to its grave. A subscriber sent me this Alienware after two shops told him that the motherboard needs to be replaced. Well, let's see if we can fix this motherboard instead. The first thing I see is that it won't turn on, and the light turns off on the charger. I will need to pull this motherboard out and get it under the microscope and thermal camera. Using my multimeter, I find that there's a dead short on the main power rail. I will inject 1 volt and monitor the thermal camera for a shorted component. There, did you see that light up? This tiny capacitor on CPU V-core is cracked and shorted the ground. I will replace both of these here to prevent a future failure. Okay, the short is gone. Will it turn on? Boom, sweet success. If you need a repair, link is in our bio. I got another mail-in laptop repair, and it's a huge Alienware gaming laptop. This customer said he was trying to replace his keyboard and ripped the LCD ribbon connector. This happens quite often on this board because of where the connector is located. Let me take a look. Yep, this connector is completely damaged and the board will need to be replaced. Let me grab a new one from the warehouse. But wait, what fun is that? Let me show you how I replace these connectors. Okay, it's time to remove the board and get it under the microscope. First, I will remove remove the old connector completely and clean the contacts. And then I will prepare the pad for a new connector. All right, now that the connector is on, time to test. Awesome, I saved this guy $400. Gaming laptops have a high death rate, which is why I was not surprised when this Alienware gaming laptop got delivered today because it wouldn't stay on. To figure out if this laptop has a failing GPU, I will need to boot into Windows and disable the Nvidia graphics card and run some stress tests. The laptop is running fine on the Intel integrated GPU, but what happens when I enable the Nvidia GPU? I'll restart the stress test and boom. Just like that, the laptop shuts off. This is bad news because the GPU is built on the motherboard and cannot be replaced. But let's remove the motherboard and get it under the microscope and see if we can fix the issue. This Nvidia GPU is powered by these three MOSFETs, and one of them is failing. Which one? I don't know. And I don't care because I replaced all of them to prevent a future problem. Now that we have a fresh set of GPU V-Core MOSFETs, moment of truth. Sweet success. We need a repair, link is in our bio. This $3,000 laptop has a keyboard you cannot use. The keyboard refuses to work when booted into Windows, and you are forced to use a USB keyboard like this one. But here's the strange thing, it works fine in the laptop BIOS. And guess what? This is a known issue affecting Alienware X17 R1 and R2 laptops. Dell recommends a motherboard replacement, but users say the issue returns after a few months. So this subscriber sent me his laptop to see if I could figure it out. And here's what I found. This keyboard is actually connected to the laptop through a USB interface. And you can see that when booted to Windows, the device shows up with an unknown USB descriptor, preventing it from starting. If I measure the keyboard USB data line, I can see that it never goes completely low when it needs to, and it gets stuck in a floating state. But shout out to MBs who posted the solution to this issue. By adding a 1K resistor to ground on the negative data line, this pulls the pen low when no data is present, fixing the issue. And so now I could no longer say that, well, another mail-in laptop showed up. Let me see what it is. Ooh, looky, it's a huge Alienware. Let me take a look and see what's wrong with it. The customer's note says it no longer turns on. Well, yep, no worky. I'll open it up and take some measurements. I'm getting voltage on the motherboard from the DC power circuit and the battery power circuit, which is a good thing. Okay, I will remove the board and see if I can fix it. The board is missing the 5-volt and the 3.3-volt rails. After spending some time working on this board, I found that this power MOSFET is not turning on, and it is preventing power from the rest of the board. I replaced the MOSFET just in case, but it did not fix it. The problem is with the PCH, which tells the MOSFET to turn on. So unfortunately, I'll be unable to fix this motherboard. Do you think the customer should buy a new motherboard for $750 or just buy a new laptop?
Well, that ain't good. Can you tell what's wrong with this one?
This laptop was brought into my shop by a subscriber. He said that he was replacing one of the fans on this Alienware and ripped the LCD connector right off the board. I've replaced many of these LVDS connectors on this exact model laptop because of its odd placement. It gets ripped off easily. I can replace this without removing the motherboard, but I will need to protect the area. First, I will remove what is left of this old LVDS connector. Then I will need to clean and prep the pads. A little flux, and now the new connector. After soldering each pin and cleaning up the area, time to connect the cable. And moment of truth, success.